Best Bites Forever.
Hi everyone, welcome to Best Bites Forever. I'm Alicia and today I'm going to show you how to make this really simple recipe for macaroni and cheese. I love this recipe, my kids love this recipe, and one of the things that I really love about it is that it is not only easy to make, but you can make it in about the same amount of time as you would the boxed macaroni and cheese. And my little girl's favorite food in the world is like boxed macaroni and cheese, which is totally cool and totally fine. But every now and then she'll be like, Mom, can I have the macaroni and cheese? But not in that voice because she doesn't sound like that, but that's my imitation of her. So anyway, every now and then she asks me for some macaroni and cheese and I go over to the pantry and I'm like, oh, freaking crap, I got macaroni and cheese. I can't make it for her. But like, I'll have some other random noodle in there. So you can make your own macaroni and cheese. You just make the noodles and then you make this sauce, which is super, super, super simple. In this particular video, I am using blue cheese and cheddar cheese, but only a teeny little bit of blue cheese. So if you don't want to use the blue cheese, it's cool. Just leave it out, switch it out with a different kind of cheese. You can use all cheddar. You can make this your own. You can use whatever kind of cheese you want, as long as it's like a melty cheese and as long as you kind of stay within the same portions of the recipe. Cool? Cool. All right, let's go do it.
I am starting off here with a quarter cup of butter, which I have melted, and I'm adding a quarter cup of all-purpose flour into that, and I just want to stir that around until it gets mixed together. And I don't know why I'm using my wooden spatula for this, because a whisk works much better. So that's better, I switched it out. Just continue to whisk that together until it comes together. Stop every couple of seconds, take a look at it, see if you're getting bubbles. If you are, that's great. Just continue to whisk until it smells really, really good. It takes about a minute. You want to keep this like a light color. Sometimes you want to cook your roux until it's like a little bit darker, but in this case, we want to keep it nice and light. Here I have 2 cups of whole milk. If you want to make this a little bit richer, you can use cream instead. And my milk is warm. I'm just adding it into my roux a little bit at a time. My roux is that flour butter mixture that we made just a minute ago. So I'm just whisking in my warm milk a little bit at a time, making sure that I don't have any clumps as I'm going. Once I get it all mixed in, I want to bring it up to a simmer, and I also want to switch to my spatula because I want to make sure that nothing is sticking to the bottom at all. Once this thickens up, which takes only about a minute or so, you are ready to add in your cheese. You need 8 ounces of cheese altogether. You can use whatever combination you want to. I'm using 6 ounces of shredded cheddar along with 2 ounces of Gorgonzola cheese. You don't have to do the blue cheese. You can do all cheddar. You can put really whatever kind of melty cheese in here that you want to. Just stir it together with your spatula until it comes together into a nice little sauce. I also am going to turn the heat off at this point because that milk mixture is plenty hot enough to melt the cheese. So once you get that to a nice creamy consistency, and I do have like a few little bits of my Gorgonzola still in there, which I'm totally fine with, you can mix it in with the noodles. I just made 10 ounces of rotini according to the package instructions, and I drained it and put like just a tiny bit of olive oil so it wouldn't stick together while I was making my sauce. This is stirred up and it is ready to serve. It's that easy.
Hi again, thank you so much for watching my video. Please give it a like and a thumbs up and share it with all of your friends because sharing is caring. And if you're not already a subscriber, be sure to go ahead and subscribe now. Thank you so much for watching and happy cooking, everyone.
BestBitesForever.com